Hello, hello, everybody. It is 6:28 p.m. Central Time on the 4th of October, 2020. It's Sunday here in the United States, and I hope you're doing well. I've got some somewhat strange breaking news to bring to you, and I think I'm going to upload this when I'm done here live on Twitch, and we will upload this over on YouTube and premiere it. You guys just need to see what's going on, and I'll let you decide for yourselves. I'll explain what I think's going on in a second here, but first things first, let's turn on a display capture so you can see what I see. And I'm going to bring you over here to GOES 16 satellite. And just to give you a perspective of some of the things that are going on, we've got big fires that have been going on out west. We're looking at the shortwave infrared view. And hotspots, or fires in this case, are going to show up as black splotches on the map. And this one's, you know, 20,000 acres burning in southern Wyoming. Just to give you an example of what a fire looks like when it breaks out on a windy day. And that's what's going on right now over here at the Wyoming-Colorado border. But that's not why I've got you on here. I need to bring you over here to the Midwest. And I'm going to show you something that I've never seen happen before. And then we're going to talk about what we think it might mean. Okay? So first things first, you just need to see it for yourself. This is today's imagery. You can go verify me on any GOES 16 viewer and turn on the thermal imaging or the shortwave infrared. And I want to focus in here right on southern Missouri and watch. Now, each one of these black splotches that shows up, I'd like to clear up first. There are no major control burns going on, and each one of these flare-offs of heat is being detected anywhere between 500 Kelvin and 900 Kelvin, anywhere between 800 degrees Fahrenheit and 1100 to 1200 degrees Fahrenheit. And they're going for 5 minutes. Maybe, or 10 minutes, flaring on and off. And I'm just going to move it back and forth. Now, this is matching with an area that we all know about and have at least have heard about, the New Madrid Seismic Zone. I live just west of St. Louis up here, right up here, just about 75 miles west of St. Louis. And here, down in the New Madrid Seismic Zone, we've got something going on with a flare-off of heat signatures. And then we can go over to Google, where I've got the GOES 16 satellite place marks for the fires that are being detected. And we can just click on some of these. This is the New Madrid Seismic Zone right here. New Madrid is right in the middle. I've got a place mark on it where it is. And I'd also like to draw your attention to all of these, which are also showing up as fire signatures. And each set of these should match something that I think many of my viewers have seen in the past, which is this, the craton edge on the inside of it. But these are not exactly wildfires, and they're not farmers burning their fields. Again, each one's 5 minutes long, and it's a burst of heat. I'll click on just one. Here's one, fire detection centroid, good fire pixel, detected today. And look at this, 917K, which we measured out as about 1100 to 1200 degrees Fahrenheit. And that is just one of many that's showing up here, several detected on top of each other, and it's only focused here, matching a perfect match on the inside of the New Madrid Seismic Zone. Now, where have we seen hotspot breakouts like this before? Well, the only other examples we have on, I don't have any other previous examples like this to show in the Midwest. I would have to take you over here to California, where we have all the hotspot signatures around where our wildfires are, around our volcanoes. For instance, this is a super volcano here at the California-Nevada border called Long Valley and Mammoth Mountain right in the middle. And look at the ring that the fire is making around the other side of the super volcano. And that's just one example of many. We got another one right down here. Hotspot. This is California now, where we have a ring of volcanoes, which is a caldera of an ancient super volcano. And right next to it, we've got a bunch of fires taking place over on the West Coast in big clusters like that. Again, let's go back over to College of DuPage and look at the visible satellite imagery. We're going to go into a localized sector now and look down here first in southern Missouri. Then we'll go over to the Indiana-Kentucky border region where the other little outbreak is taking place. I shouldn't say little, the other big outbreak of hotspot signatures. So what could cause a dramatic release of heat like its fire flaring off here and there across the whole southern New Madrid, southern Missouri seismic zone, and then disappear? What could cause all of that if it's not control burns, which we know it isn't, and it's not farmers burning their fields, and each one's 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit or so? It's a burst of heat coming from the middle of the N-shaped bend in the New Madrid seismic zone, which I can show you over here on my map here, which I've had on here for years, the edge of the North American Craton. And in the middle of it is where our heat signatures are taking place. Now, in the middle over to the east, let's go back over to Google Earth and look over to the east. Here's the New Madrid with all its flare-offs going down the Mississippi River Valley. Now, you guys remember the story of the great New Madrid earthquake back in 1811? When there were sudden bursts coming out of the ground, not just sand geysers, bursts of heat and steam reported. Flashes of light, too. But over to the east, this cluster matches on the edge of the Wabash Valley seismic zone. But to see the New Madrid or the Wabash, I'm going to turn off all the place marks for a second here. And again, this is the N-shaped bend of the New Madrid seismic zone. And these are foothills that go through Arkansas and back up into southern Missouri. Let me make sure you guys can see all this. And then it makes a U-shaped bend down through Alabama and Mississippi. That's the New Madrid. But going up this way like a horn or a curve coming off of the New Madrid, that is the Wabash Valley seismic zone that goes up into Ohio up here. These are the two most dangerous seismic zones, according to professionals, in the United States. So now let's compare where our fires are again. Or our hotspot outbreaks, I should say, because they're not really fires. It's a smack match for right on the west side of the New Madrid and right on the west side of the Wabash Valley. These hotspots just popping up suddenly today, and I don't have any previous examples to go on to tell you what to expect off this. Now, I live here, and I can tell you this. If I saw this going out in California like this, let's say this was happening down in another very active seismic. Let's say this happened across LA. If this happened across LA, I would warn Southern California, all of Southern California, for the potential of a large earthquake. And I would look for the rest of the week, at least, for that. Just because the amount of heat that it would take to cause something like this, first of all, to shoot up through the plate, and for it to match the New Madrid seismic zone, oh man. It's just too big of a coincidence. We have to watch now for the next week, and I have to, well, dust off my emergency kits, because this could lead to a... If this is a release of heat from the plate shifting or bending somehow, then we do have to watch for the potential of a large quake. Another way to look at this is, this is all happening about 2 weeks after the West Coast shifted. Over on the West Coast, we had a slow slip with thousands, well, actually more than 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. And then this past week, another quick slip of a few hundred and 4.0 range activity, almost five. Well, it was a five. It was up to a 5.8 that struck down here in Southern California just a few days back. Now, all of a sudden, over here on the edge of the Craton over to the east, a sudden hot spot outbreak. Now, I'd like to look at this at visible satellite just to see. Let's go look at natural color fire visible for the day and hit play. So here we are last night going into this morning. There we are. We start throughout the day. There's our cold front that blew through. It's just getting cold and... Whoa. There was a flash or something there. Hold on. There was some kind of beam that just took off. Guys, there was some kind of... Hold on. What? No. Oh, no. Okay, what is this frame? October 4th, 2020 at 1926:15 UTC. Everybody go verify this on your own version of GOES. This is a beam? Hold on. Are you kidding me? All right, we need to go look back out at a regional sector on this, on the visible. What is that? What is this funny business? Somebody put this on there. Some National Weather Service person trying to play a joke on us or something. Are you kidding me? Look, this is going down where the fire is in northern Colorado. What is This is foolishness. Okay, it's not, that beam is not, that is foolishness now, okay? This is, that to me looks like somebody's playing around and playing a game. Let's go hit play on this view, the regional view. I can't believe that. That is showing up as bright purple on the fire view. There. Okay, it looks like it's coming from up in Ohio. Let's go up into Ohio. Take a look. This is. Oh, not Ohio. Iowa. We're going up into Iowa. And this would be looking down. That's northern Missouri at the bottom middle of the screen. Okay, so this one's going. Wow, look at that. Look at that. Look how it takes a step down, or maybe it's coming up. Is that... Oh, my God. Okay. Something is going on, guys. Something very odd that I've never seen before. Are we looking at direct energy weapons again? Is somebody playing a joke on us? This is some kind of hoax put out by the National Weather Service. What if it's a disgruntled employee and they're causing this to look like it? They're populating it from the National Weather Service office or something. Because this is official GOES satellite imagery here. Anybody can go look this up on any feed they want. I use College of DuPage because I'm familiar with it and it's easy to access for everyone. Let's go back to the shortwave and now we're just looking at shortwave infrared. And I'm going to look at particle size near infrared in just a second too now. Now that we have some kind of weird beams populating in on the screen here. That is just foolishness. Okay, there's all our hotspot signatures. Same time that the beams are supposedly going on the screen, but you can't see them because the beam is in natural color fire view, particle infrared. Let's go to particle. Now we should see the same thing, okay, throughout the day. Now, it might be a little harder to see for the hotspot signatures because it's going to accentuate the clouds a little bit more. But we should still be able to see it. There, okay, you can see these little flashes going across southern Missouri. Now, it's not showing up on particle near infrared. It's only showing up on the thermal visible view. Visible thermal view. Which is so suspect. Let's go to the natural color view and just see. The chances of having the beam go down into the same area where there's a bunch of hot spots is just phenomenal because it's not like they're bright or something. People said previously, when that happened a couple weeks ago with the directed energy weapon out on the West Coast, they said that was just a reflection off the fires. Well, these aren't visible fires. These are hotspots showing up down in the New Madrid seismic zone, and we have a big purple something or other going right down into the center of it. There, right there. But what's so weird about this is we go look at the regional view of the greater view, and the beam is going a different way on the screen. So it's going west and east there. And... there, okay, now it's... okay, maybe we were just lagging a few frames behind. Okay, I mean, what do we want to make of this? Should we go look and see what's up here in North Iowa? See if there's anything there? Because I would think this would be up in space, beaming down at an angle. And it would be more like over Missouri, beaming down. Or it would put the craft or whatever it is somewhere up here in between here and here, and it went from here to here. Either way, we've got a bunch of hotspots showing up at a time where there's a beam going down into the area. It can't be chance or coincidence. This is now bright purple on the screen. What does that even show? What is our color key on this? Well, I can tell you for certain that the color key won't cover directed energy weapon beams, at least not yet. We'll have to add the Dutch sense mode to this viewer for that. but maybe they should make it a rainbow color and add some sound effects for this dang thing. Let's go back over to the natural color fire view. The chances of having it shine down in there is just so phenomenally, insanely low for it to just be chance, or insane high chances. It would be almost impossible for it to be chance, is what I'm getting at. So either somebody's totally trolling us from the National Weather Service and populating in fake data, populating in fake hotspots, populating in fake beams, but now we're getting to a level of conspiracy. And I'm talking conspiracy amongst people at the National Weather Service to try and hide something or goof around or troll us. How else would you explain it? You couldn't have that many coincidences. You couldn't have that many accidents. And so something's up. And that then leads me back to what this could be. I mean, if it's not a troll, if it's not a National Weather Service hoax, but that, if that is, that's troubling. Everybody should get fired. If they're hoaxing using official stuff, I mean, you guys go look this up. Our date and timestamps are down here at the bottom of the screen. So let me just pause it and get our date and timestamps, so you guys know what to look up on. You can use visual. There's our first. There, right there. And that comes in at the 4th of October, 2020 at 17:06:15 UTC. And this is on the regional view, but let's go to the continental view. Let's do the whole continental view here. We've got a bunch of smoke from the fires out in California. So what's going on? Are they hoaxing us and then putting in a bunch of hotspots down in the New Madrid to scare us? Wouldn't that be crazy? Which is more crazy? For them to try and hoax us and try and scare us that way, or for this to be real? There. Oh, look, it's going through the clouds! It looks like it's going through the clouds, doesn't it? Here, let me zoom back in on that, because let's go back up here to Michigan. Or is that just waving out? I mean, if that is just waving out, then that's a wave of some kind. Some kind of energy beam, because it would be oscillating, and oscillating would go in and out of the spectrum that's visible on this near-infrared and visible view. Okay. Wow. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, if somebody's faking it, what is over there in Lake Michigan or in North Iowa? North Central Iowa. Let's turn on our borders and labels and just kind of zoom in around there and see if there's anything weird up there. What do we got up here? Oh, man. I'll tell you what. I don't know what to make. Oh, look at the name of the place. Oh, my God. Yeah. Okay, we're out of here. Let's go over to the east. What's over here? Hey, look, a hotspot signature. A fire detection centroid is there off of Lake Michigan. It's within 20 miles. Here's the fire detection centroid. And here's our peninsula that goes out to the west in Michigan. And we get back over to Google Earth. Here's our peninsula that goes out over to the west in Michigan, and that might be 50 miles to the south at the most. Again, like the beams coming into right down here, and the hotspots right next to it. There's only two in all of Michigan. That cannot be a chance. There's a hotspot signature right where the beam is coming in there. And here in Iowa, or actually up here in Iowa. Wow. And there is a hotspot over here in western Iowa right next to it. Now, Mason City is over here on the east. I want to see, but it would be above it, I think. I think this would be up in space. You would think, unless they're beaming this up as a high-powered microwave and reflecting it off the upper ionosphere and back down again with an artificial ionosphere spheric mirror reflector. But that would require a lot of knowledge on radio waves and plasma physics to do that, and some facilities. Let's hit play again and just look across the whole area. This is on our natural color fire view. If it is a mistake, it's the biggest mistake in the world to have it go into the same spot where we're having all the hot spots. So I think we might be looking at something going on here that's legit. Something like that, beaming down into here, and then right next to it, the New Madrid seismic zone. Imagine this at an angle now. You've got to imagine this like something way up above here in space beaming down and out. And it does look like it's going through the clouds. It really does. I mean, it could be a mistake. Look, there's a yellow line coming off of this one. Now there's a yellow line coming in and going down into, oh wait, it's shooting down into the spots that are the hot spots down in southern Indiana that are detected. Let's go back down here and look. How close are we? Oh yeah. Yeah, look at this. And then we go back over. You might not be able to see the yellow beam here, but it's very hard to see. Let me zoom in on the area. Oh my God. I cannot believe this is happening. Because, I mean, for me to catch the first round. Okay, there's our first. It's scattering out. Somebody's either trolling us or that's legit. There it is. There's our yellow beam coming off of the purple beam. And it's going, if we were to follow this straight down in a line, it goes right down to where all those hotspots are. And again, I'm looking at this three-dimensionally. So again, if it's shooting down this way and it's going right down to here, and the other beam is shooting right down to here, and it right next to it, all the hotspots. And the East Coast. I haven't even checked all the way up here in Maine and Pennsylvania yet, but I probably should. At this point, we're going to need to go over to Maine and Pennsylvania and see what the deal is there. And hit play and just see if anything shows up. This is the most wild adventure that I've ever been on. Oh, wait. Hey, look. So the beam comes over and we can't see it anymore. It disappears either into the clouds or fades out. But you can see how the beam takes a step down as it goes in to a finer point. Or maybe it's expanding. Maybe it's coming from the ground there, going up and expanding and coming back down. But if you were to follow this trajectory over to the east with the curvature of the earth, look where it puts us. Puts us in New York. And then we get back over here and look at the fires. Well, there's New York. We got a bunch up there in New York. So what about the one in Pennsylvania? Well, let's just take a look. See if it goes any further. Oh, yeah. The second transmission, if you will, or troll. Either we're getting trolled or this is real. I'm not doing anything, by the way. I'm just showing you what's going on. But this is alarming to me now as we go back and go over to the shortwave infrared and look down in southern Missouri. Even at this height, we should be able to see all of these hot spots, these little flare-offs of heat, down in southern Missouri, down here in the New Madrid seismic zone. The cloud cover is obscuring whatever's going on at the Indiana-Kentucky border region. But I am worried about that. Look over to the west, all the oil wells flaring off over in Kansas. Let's go over to Kansas and take a look really quick, because additionally, we have oil wells flaring off. So this is Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas, and Arkansas, and Missouri. So this should show us all the oil wells flaring off. Watch this. Something's going on. They don't normally flare off unless they've got something. They're trying to get rid of a lot of gas, or there's some kind of overpressure that's going on. Yeah, look at that. So across Kansas as well, all the oil wells, they're venting off in central Kansas, and it looks like down into Oklahoma, with a few in Arkansas as well. So in addition to the New Madrid seismic zone, we've got oil wells flaring off. And to give you an example of something that normally flares off all the time, we can go down into like Texas and look up here in West Texas at the oil pumping operations, and you'll see these flare off a lot. There's tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of oil wells. So just wait and wait for it for your second year. Throughout the day today. Oh, of course, you know, you can't see much. Of course, it's not showing. Okay, normally, we could go up into North Dakota and we might be able to see some. Let's see. Does it show? If they're not, yeah, they are. Okay, you could see a few up here in North Dakota at the fracking operations. They're a little hard to see, but they're the same size. They're the same flare-off shape. So I'm going to tell you guys right now, this is something I have to keep a watch on here in the Midwest at the New Madrid Seismic Zone. I'm not going to issue a forecast. I don't have any previous examples to go on like this, where we're getting a bunch of hotspots just in the New Madrid and then on the Wabash Valley Seismic Zone and on the edge of the Craton up to the east by northeast. One more time, the edge of the Craton. And if you compare the edge of the Craton to our hotspots, the red dots are the hotspots. So New Madrid, here, let me get this in view. New Madrid, Wabash Valley, edge of the Craton up at the Pennsylvania-New York border region, and all the way up here at the Maine New Brunswick border region. It's a perfect match of hotspots going all the way across the edge of the Craton. Now, here's the deal. Somebody could be trolling us at the National Weather Service. It's possible. But for it to be a match, I mean, I'm not going to discount the possibility that there could be somebody that's, you know, just playing around. But to have that level of, I mean, it would mean they would need GO 16 access. They would need the fire detection centroid access. And they would need to not be concerned with causing a fire panic for people, because everybody can use these feeds and see what's being reported. Now, seismically speaking, what could cause this? Well, the edge of the Craton could be being pushed. The whole plate could be in motion right now, in which case we should see an earthquake somewhere near where these hotspots are. And the hotspots are going from the New Madrid Seismic Zone to the Wabash Valley Seismic Zone, up the East Coast, all the way to Maine, on the edge of the Craton. That would mean somewhere between Maine and the New Madrid, we should have a big earthquake very soon. And when I say very, I guess I should say we have to use the past examples in California, where the hotspots show up in clusters, and then next thing you know, within a week, 2 weeks, we're seeing major outbreak activity, whether it's swarms or fours or fives. We've even seen some sixes pop off before in the past out on the West Coast when we get a lot of shifting. Now, I can tell you this also. Here, hold on. Let's get another display capture open. And let's just quickly go over and show you where we have other hotspots that show up. But I'm going to show you something from the PNSN tremor map, Pacific Northwest Seismic Network tremor map, up here in the Pacific Northwest. And we'll go back to the second and these little red dots. These are vibrations as the plate shifts, but we see explosions, hot spots, and fires breaking out next to where we see the shifting. We've seen that over the past several weeks and months. So does this mean that we're going to have seismic activity come rolling into the Midwest here very soon? I hope I'm wrong. Hope this doesn't mean anything. But the DEW, the directed energy weapon beam aspect on this, is so odd. Well, it's more than odd. It would be twice now that we've seen this happen in the past few weeks. But this time, it's so visible, it's showing the computer is detecting it. Either it's a mistake, a troll, or it's real. And at this point, with the hotspots being mixed in, we would have to think that it's a troll or it's real. That the mistake aspect kind of gets thrown out the window when you have the hotspots, the actual fire detection centroids being showing up at the same time the beam is there. Okay, I'm going to save this as a video, and we're going to upload this over on YouTube. We're going to keep a close watch over the next 7 days for the next week, and probably for the next 2 weeks, but just to keep it in a one-week aspect, I'll watch from today till the 11th. And at the 11th, we will reassess. We'll see if this carries on, or if it transfers, or if there's any explanation that turns up. But my radar is going off like you wouldn't even imagine. And I live here. I live right here. Okay? And I got the Michael Brown shooting on there. I grew up in Ferguson, by the way. I'm Mike from Ferguson. How ironic, right? Okay, you guys, much love. Will you have an earthquake plan? And I really mean it now. Will you please take the time to develop an emergency kit? And I'm going to go through my emergency kit. And I will tell you also, you need to know what to do in case you get displaced outside of your house. So if you're outside, you might not be coming back in for a while. So you might want to have an additional amount of supplies that you keep maybe in your car or your truck or maybe even in a trunk buried outside if you have to. But a way to keep things that you need for the next several days of a disaster if one takes place. Now, I haven't even gotten into the rest of the earthquakes that have struck. This is not really an earthquake update. But as we're scrolling by here on the screen, you can see all these fives that have spread all the way across the plate. This is within 48 hours. So the rest of the Pacific plate is in overdrive. Again, look at our fives and greater, or 4.9s and greater, in the last 48 hours. The whole West Pacific from Kamchatka across Japan, going down through Philippines, back all the way over to Fiji, all has already moved. Our volcanoes are increasing. Australia moved as expected. Central Australia, Southwest Australia, Southeast Australia. We're still waiting for Northeast Australia to move, but the rest have already moved. Check them all off the list. They were all warned. Europe even started to move pretty heavy this week. UK, Scotland. Scotland got hit up here. We have a volcano to the west of here. And Scotland got hit. But I'm here to talk about this. If my neck of the woods gets a new earthquake, and by the way, look where all the rings overlap. Right on the edge of the craton coming out of Oklahoma and Arkansas going up into the New Madrid seismic zone. To top it all off, throw in the directed energy weapon aspect, and we've got ourselves a full freaky-deaky thing going on. Figures I would get thrown this to catch today. Be safe, guys. Peace out.